There's a reason why autopilot has been around in the airplanes, but yet today we still have pilots. We're seeing a revolution take place in front of our eyes. And certainly, when you think about what the future can look like, it's very exciting. It's very exciting to be able to think about a world in which we have to do little or nothing when we get on our vehicles. Think about your vehicle. Think about all the buttons and switches in your vehicle. And think about all the technology that goes into making your vehicle work. Typically, the most effective technologies are the ones that you may not even know exist on your vehicle, where you have to do little or nothing to make it work. My name is Omar Ahmad, and I'm Deputy Director at the National Advanced Driving Simulator. We look at the connection between humans and their vehicles and how to make driving safer for everybody. We at the University of Iowa have a collection of simulators and vehicles that is very unique. We have the largest driving simulator in the United States and the second largest in the world. And when this driving simulator was built, there was really nothing else like it.
This is the National Advanced Driving Simulator, one of the largest driving simulator facilities in the world. It's here where we can put people inside that dome and move it around this basketball stadium-sized room and mimic all the forces of driving so we can do research on crash avoidance, look at how automated systems work in traffic, so a person feels and sees like a real vehicle. With this dome, when you put on the brakes, when you accelerate, when you swerve, you feel all of those forces as you drive. My name is Dan McGehee. I'm the director of the National Advanced Driving Simulator here in the University of Iowa's College of Engineering, where I teach human factors engineering and mentor a great number of students on vehicle safety, human factors, and crash analytics. One of the hallmarks of the research that we do here at this lab, whether it's on the simulator or on a closed course like an airport runway, has to do with experimental control. We want to expose drivers exactly to the same kinds of things every time so that we can make very specific comparisons in our research. So the work that we do out on a closed course, whether it's an airport runway or a test track or the simulator, we can put those drivers into the same situation exactly the same way.
For the past few years, we've been looking at the idea of automated vehicle technologies. And it's clear that there's a lot of testing that's taking place in bigger cities and in areas with highways and near perfect weather. And then we looked at that and we looked at what we have in Iowa. And Iowa is a four-season state and we have different kinds of roadways. We have highways with slow-moving vehicles like tractors, school buses, and other farm implements. This is a very common situation in Iowa. And if you're going to have universal adoption of automated vehicles, then our automated vehicles need to be able to handle the different kinds of real-world driving situations that you encounter in states like Iowa.
Agricultural equipment looks very different than what a computer might train for in terms of what a car, a pedestrian, a bicycle looks like. So we actually have a project where we squawk a signal, we broadcast a signal from a slow-moving tractor who might be driving just around the corner in a 55-mile-an-hour area. School buses are critical. They come to a full stop in our rural environments, and they are often hit from behind around those kinds of corners. We're doing the same kind of thing, broadcasting a signal, so that vehicle, whether it's in an automated mode or even a human driving mode, they give an alert to make sure that a person has enough reaction time to be able to avoid those kinds of vehicles in the road. While it will be many decades before you see robots driving down the streets and a robot that will pick you up to take you to work, we are taking a look at how regular driving and that transitionary period from manually to fully automatic driving is occurring. And Iowa streets are uniquely designed and also have limitations in terms of some rural roads don't have paint. We have a lot of gravel roads. So if we can solve some of the most complex driving conditions, we will be able to not only help Iowa first, but the nation and the world.